Launched by President Museveni in the academic year 2014-2015 with only 1,201 beneficiaries, the numbers of students who have benefited from the loan scheme has steadily increased to 12,780 in 2022, and these have pursued degrees and diploma courses in science, technology, engineering, and math programs.
And I'm aware that even someone who has done maybe history, economics and geography, or mathematics, economics and geography, can be given information technology. That has been allowed because we still have very few people with the relevant skills and the competences in IT. So we want to grow that trade or discipline.
Michael Wanyama, the Executive Director for Higher Education Students Financing Board, said that the board noted that students in the universities, which have just acquired the charter, would also like to benefit from the scheme. That's why they have decided to extend the deadline for the loan applications. A charter is granted to universities that have demonstrated high quality in staffing, teaching and learning, research output, extension services, infrastructure development, and quality assurance.
We had closed our application by 15 September, but we just recently received the charter from Victoria University and said we can't lock out the students who are joining Victoria University. So we have extended our deadline to 15th October.
We are trying to build a different type of education that fits anyone who lives today. And today is dominated by a world driven by technology.
To qualify for the student's loan scheme, you must be a Ugandan and you must have been admitted to a recognized education institution for either a diploma or a degree. The applicant must also demonstrate that they are needy and cannot afford paying tuition. Government came up with this program to cater for the underprivileged bright students, but also those with disabilities to access higher learning.
But we also have a group that we support totally for affirmative action. If you're a person with a disability, we don't discriminate any program that you have been given to pursue because we know the challenges that you go through to reach that level.
The board has decided to put on board students offering humanities because some of the courses are critical for Uganda's development. Initially, they were only considering science students.
But we also have again other programs which you can be admitted for even when you have done arts course at the Uganda Advanced Certificate of Education. You can be admitted to do, we have what we call bachelors of speech, bachelors of special needs, then bachelors of teacher education with special needs.
According to the Higher Education Students Financing Act 2014, repayment of the loan shall be charged on the income of the person who received the loan a year after the beneficiary has completed studies, whether employed or not. The Act provides for a six-month jail sentence or a fine of at most 1 million shillings to beneficiaries who try to default after graduating. Employers who fail to remit a specified percentage of the beneficiary's salaries to service the loan also face a 10-year jail sentence or a fine of 10 million shillings.
So we don't inconvenience you in any way when you have even completed the studies, because the period in which you are supposed to pay this money is long enough to leave you with what can sustain you as a person and what you can pay back to us. Actually, as per the law, we recover not more than 30% of your income.
Because of the low student loan recovery, officials from the Higher Education Students Financing Board have hinted on coming up with a detailed plan to retain the students' transcripts after graduation or put a mark on them to indicate that they are beneficiaries of the scheme so that when they apply for any job, the employer will have to automatically deduct the percentage for the loan recovery. Story by Jaliat Namwaya for the news.